aches in darkness. Aching cold sets into an unfamiliar body. Your first emotion is an involuntary and formless panic. You feel you have forgotten something, something important. As if it once meant the world to you, but the details slip away as you grasp at them. You force your eyes open. A white-pink fleshy cocoon surrounds you. Even as you look, a minor rent in its side tears open, and the howling wind forces its way inside. The cocoon rips away, gone before you can grab it, spinning you into a dizzying tumble. You are falling, the world many kilometers beneath you. You catch a glimpse of a curved horizon, and also the ground beneath you that is approaching deceptively quickly. Above you, a small moon is slowly collapsing in upon itself, a corona of acid green and black energy playing around its edges. The wind buffets you and burns your eyes, but you don't need to see the details of the faraway ground to know you're in serious trouble. You won't survive a fall from this stratospheric height. A part of your frantic mind babbles that technically you probably fell from a thermospheric height. You struggle to stay focused as the ground rushes toward you. Instinctively, you spread your arms and legs, and they respond sluggishly. You stop tumbling head over heels. Though you are still spinning laterally, that motion has calmed as well, and you have space to assess your situation, and perhaps to understand the predicament and the body in which you find yourself. Below you, you see a large landmass. A massive ocean dominates the rest of the visible globe, dotted here and there with island chains. Now you see that this appears to be a huge megacontinent, the only land of any size, on this side of the world at least. Great inland seas and lakes dot the land, and curiously, regular mountain ranges march up and down and across. You are falling toward what looks to be a great bay, a sprawling city perched on its shore just to the north. Further to the north and east, you see a broad plain scattered with curious structures visible even from this height. The northeastern portion of this land looks to be a desert, a strange blue dot like an eye in its exact center. It seems to hold a city in its watery grasp. To its west is a ring of huge mountains surmounted by enormous carved peaks spewing magma into a central catch basin. What concerns you most right now is the bay below you. It's coming at you quickly. It's fruitless. You've reached a velocity that could, without irony, best be named terminal. You spread your arms and legs and try to catch a draft, and it looks like you'll hit the bay that's rushing toward you, unless you hit the building in its littered waters. A strange web of colors surrounds you, thrown by a figure standing on the balcony of the structure, but it is effective only at slowing your fall. You strike the building hard enough to crack its crystalline structure, and you hear one of the engines that supports it protest and howl. And the agony of the crash overcomes you, and then, darkness.
Where did he fall from? His body smashed to talc. It's a wonder he's still breathing.
All I saw was the corona, not his origin point. But look, he's healing already. Spontaneous regeneration.
Thank you.
don't like the smell of this dome.
We should not tarry in this chamber long. No doubt others saw your dramatic entrance as well.